So there seems to be a lot of interest in the 4K version of The Revenant, and I'm not surprised. It's an amazing movie, one of the best movies I've seen in a while. And I think this is the kind of movie that really helps show off the power of 4K and HDR, just because of all of the sort of the outdoor locations, which is the vast majority of the film. I think Wild, when I first heard that was being released, it's a movie I haven't seen, but I know a lot of it takes place. In the forest, I thought that would be a movie that was one of the best early releases. But from what I've read, review-wise, they've been very underwhelmed by the transfer. So, thought I'd give you another quick look at The Revenant on Blu-ray versus 4K. Now, keep in mind a couple of things. First of all, this is a Blu-ray being upscaled, not by the what I'm playing it out of, because the television itself is a 4K panel, so the television's processor upscales images anyway. So you don't necessarily need to have an upscaler if you have a 4K television, because the television's processor does it. The Samsung player, though, is an upscaler as well. I'm not playing this out of the Samsung player, the Blu-ray version. I'm playing the 4K version out of the player, so I can switch back and forth. And I thought I'd give you another quick look and s let you see what The Revenant sort of has turned out to be on Blu-ray and 4K. So first up, as usual, is the Blu-ray version. Don't go too crazy on the size here. The volume down on this. So you can see all the detail in the hairs in his coat and the water, that kind of thing. It's beautiful. I mean, I'm a big fan of Blu-ray as well, so I'm not trying to tell anybody to buy one or the other. I'm just trying to give you a fair comparison. One of the things you also have to take note of is when I show you the HDR version, the 4K version of this, is that my camera is capable of taking HDR photos, but I don't think it takes HDR video. So you're just going to be seeing it. The colors essentially may look the same to you from what you're viewing, but you know, from my point of view, sitting here watching it, I can see the difference in the variations of color and shade and the dirt and the, you know, the way this, how bright the snow is. It's a very, very beautiful movie on 4K. Worth the extra money? Well, that's really up to you, and if you have a 4K panel or not. I don't know that I'd rush out to get a 4K panel just for one movie, but I think when I look at everything else that's coming and some of the titles that are available already, this is definitely worth it. Anyway, I hope that helps some people out there who are considering. Have a great day.